a Filipino-American historian, warns that the Supreme Court's landmark ruling, issued on Monday, granting presidents immunity for official acts, strikes a deeply alarming chord among Americans.
The Supreme Court basically just handed, you know, additional protections to the executive branch, and in a way is kind of giving this branch of government additional powers.
History professor James Zarzadias says the historic ruling undermines the balance of power among the three branches of the United States government, which are meant to have equal authority.
What we've been seeing with these recent rulings is the Supreme Court has not only shown it is a conservative-leaning or solidly conservative court, beyond that, it's actually what is being demonstrated and put on full display is that this is a Trump court.
The ruling originated from a case filed by former President Donald Trump's lawyers to dismiss a federal indictment against him. Trump faces charges for allegedly attempting to overturn the 2020 elections during the chaotic final days of his presidency. His lawyers argued that a president has absolute immunity from criminal prosecution. In a 6-3 decision, the justices granted Trump a partial victory, ruling that former U.S. presidents cannot be prosecuted for official actions taken while in office.
And it's a dangerous precedent, because the power of the office will no longer be constrained by the law, even including the Supreme Court of the United States. The only limits will be self-imposed by the president alone.
The court did not decide on charges related to election tampering, sending the case back to the trial court to determine if any charges fall outside Trump's presidential duties. They also limited the evidence prosecutors can use, making it more challenging to prosecute a former president.
This is just going to, you know, in some ways, potentially, kill off those opportunities to essentially prosecute him or bring more additional charges to the things that he's been accused of and that he's been dealing with for quite some time.
In addition to the federal election interference case, Trump faces charges of election interference in Georgia and mishandling classified documents in another federal case. Meanwhile, new prosecutors on Tuesday have agreed not to oppose Trump's request to postpone his sentencing scheduled on July 11 in the hush money trial, where he was convicted in May on 34 felony counts of falsifying business records. His sentencing in this case has been moved to September 18. Lenn Almadin Thornhill, ABS-CBN News.